The age of Alexander continues.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing in at 200 pounds, Cedric Alexander!
Cedric Alexander's had a lot of ups and downs in his career, but I admire the heck out of him for committing to a new career direction.
Now, Alexander's held the Cruiserweight title, tag team titles, but tonight, Cedric looks for even more success. Cedric Alexander, former Cruiserweight champion, former Raw tag team champion.
But listen, he's got a bright future.
Savant, anything he invests in turns to gold.
I wonder if he'll invest in my health food line.
Even Grimes' luck has its limits. Cameron Grimes looking to add a few more zeros to his bank account, courtesy of the winner's purse. Cedric Alexander is one heck of an athlete, but lately, it's his intensity, or perhaps over-enthusiasm, that has been the topic of discussion.
Since when is intensity or enthusiasm a bad thing? Especially in Cedric's case, as it's only helped him when it comes to the win-loss column. Like you said, Cole, Cedric's quite the athlete, but...
Smooth trip. Good job getting in the ropes there. Yeah, that could have been bad.
They'll take things into the ring.
Looking for the suplex.
That powerbomb was absolutely worthy of both halves of its name.
Drop right across the neck. Oh, saw it coming. Two.
Getting that shoulder up seemed to be pretty easy.
Oh, I missed you. I wanted to knee you in the face again.
What does Cameron Grimes need to do to clear a path to the win here tonight, Corey?
Well,
perfect time to attack when his guard is down.
Ah, heel hook. Look at this. Oh, that's so painful.
Hard to watch, too.
Is it enough here? And he gets the shoulder up before two.
That's still a quick kick out at this point. Oh, using the knee as a weapon. A bit of intimidation tactics from Cameron Grimes.
Oh, my goodness, what a knee strike.
The corner. Ooh. He could pin his opponent right here. Stops the count before it two.
Kicking out there really has to make his opponent question his game plan.
Big forearm.
He's looking a little off balance.
I missed you. I wanted to knee you in the face again.
First with a waistlock takedown.
Off the turnbuckles.
What's he gonna do?
From the top.
And Grimes maintaining the advantage now.
I like this opportunistic approach from Grimes. Not afraid to play a little dirty.
Got caught in the jaw with the knee.
Now's a chance for Cedric to get back into this match.
Springboard clothesline by Alexander.
Cover!
Shoulders are down!
And he manages to kick out in one.
He's nowhere near ready to stop fighting yet.
Right to the throat.
Escapes in a nick of time.
Back in the ring now.
I think we're gonna see it! Bloody cross!
Oh, strong knee connects.
Oh, I heard a snap!
Inflicting more damage to the leg.
Grimes isn't being given any room to recover.
Cameron's gonna be reaching for the moonshine after the match if this keeps up.
Just cranking the head.
Countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside.
Look at this. He just tossed the leg.
Was definitely not thinking about finesse with that one.
Was only thinking about dominance.
Man, what a gut buster.
He's starting to struggle here.
Yeah, as Cedric knows, this is a crucial moment of the match.
And Alexander showcasing his arsenal.
Cedric working at a peak level right now.
Right out of ringside and back to the mat. This might not be the time for Cameron to lose sight of the task at hand.
Face buster!
Cedric looking to embarrass his opponent.
Elbow finds its mark.
And he throws the opposition back into the ring.
He's got to know he's in harm's way here.
Been a tough match for this person, but right back in it, fighting back with everything they've got.
We're seeing how bad this superstar wants it.
It's all about and the pressure on Grimes continues to mount.
Yeah, the wheels are coming off the wagon for Grimes here.
Alexander lifts it up into the fisherman buster.
Cedric with a game ender.
Two. I guess the shoulder up before three.
An impressive kick out by Cameron Grimes, who's showing a lot of fight thus far.
I don't think I've ever seen Alexander so frustrated. He thought he had this in the bag, and now he has to be considering a new strategy.
That patented Alexander offense right on the button and effective as ever.
Here's another peek at some of the more memorable parts of the match.
Here is your winner, Cedric Alexander!
An important victory for him in this match.
Cedric Alexander just took his game to a new level with that performance.
Here's a man, The Miz, who is one of the most accomplished stars in the history of WWE.
Just one of the many reasons why he is the A-lister.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Hollywood, California, weighing in at 221 pounds, The Miz!
Think for a moment about all the great adversity Miz has had to overcome in his career. He has been stalked by maniacs. He's had his manhood questioned, and he is constantly put in harm's way.
Well, I have no sympathy for The Miz. It's about time he gets humbled.
Shouldn't be humbled, he should be celebrated as a man, as a competitor, and beloved by all. The one, the only, Logan Paul.
And his opponent from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 185 pounds, Logan Paul.
Well, love him or hate him, his career is off to an amazing start.
You're right, Saxton. This guy nearly ended the 800-plus day Universal title reign of Roman Reigns in just his third match.
Oh, guys, I cannot wait for this match. Or for that matter, Logan's next podcast.
You're really trying to get a guest spot, aren't you, Corey?
So?
Corey's got his own podcast, you idiot.
Love him or hate him, you have to respect The Miz. He's clawed and climbed his way back to the upper echelon of WWE.
To love him is to admire him. And to hate him is pure jealousy, Cole. Everyone wants to sell The Miz short, and that's what's fueled his fire for years. He takes every chance he gets to prove his doubters wrong.
It would never be a good idea to enter the ring against Miz and doubt him, because if you don't take him seriously, The Miz will make you pay dearly.
And he'll be facing off with a very polarizing Logan Paul.
Of course he's polarizing, Saxton. That's what happens when you achieve Paul's level of success. He has everything that you could possibly want, and then some.
He's able to sidestep there.
To the gut.
Ooh, stiff punch.
Measuring.
Ooh, face stop.
The Miz looking a little bit shaken.
Dealing out some damage and looking good doing it.
And he sends him into the corner.
Trapped in the corner.
Oh, multiple punches.
There's non-stop blows.
Stomping.
Look, Logan Paul is one heck of an athlete, but he has to know he's nowhere near the veteran skill or in-ring IQ of Miz. So while he should naturally rely on his athleticism, hopefully he doesn't try to bite off more than he can chew and try to do things in the ring he has no business doing. Because we all know...
Up high!
You gotta be kidding me!
And after that, you know things have just kicked up a notch.
Pedal to the metal right now.
Goodness gracious.
Uh-oh. Elbow drop.
And that one misses the mark.
The Miz hot dog.
Maybe that was some of
it. And Paul caught by surprise. Not a snapmare driver plants him.
Believe what I'm seeing right now.
No one can.
Go, go.
Suplex. Oh. Here it comes.
Nicely done.
And he's able to counter.
Series of reversals.
And that was a successful bit of offense with that maneuver.
Go right to the kidneys.
Golly.
These gentlemen get after it. Here are the highlights.
Here is your winner, Logan Paul.
And Logan Paul stands tall against his former mentor, The Miz.
I doubt Miz is going to let bygones be bygones in this one. Logan should probably watch his back.
That's what this business is all about, Saxton. The higher you climb up.
Oh, baby, let the good times roll. I figured you'd like this goof. You probably laugh at all his jokes, too.
I happen to find Happy Corbin extremely entertaining.
The following contest is a fatal four-way match. Making his way to the ring from Kansas City, weighing in at 275 pounds, Happy Corbin!
This story just pulls my heartstrings. It is great when good things happen to good people.
Good people? You think Happy Corbin's a good person? The amount of people he treats like absolute garbage?
Hey, Corey, did you get the invite?
I sure did. We are in the town.
Go down to Corbin.
Raise Happy Corbin.
I never got an invite, guys.
There's a reason for that. Actually, there probably a dozen.
It's Mr. Money in the Bank.
And his opponents, first representing Imperium from Vienna, Austria, weighing in at 297 pounds, Gunther!
Gentlemen, this has all the makings of an all-time classic match, and I fully expect it to deliver on that promise.
He has a big match ahead of him. Gonna need a career-making performance here tonight.
Representing the Viking Raiders from Valhalla, weighing in at 305 pounds, Ivar!
The powerhouse of the Viking Raiders, a shockingly agile big man. A man who absolutely adores a fight.
And representing the Brawling Brutes from the United Kingdom, weighing in at 253 pounds, Ridge Holland!
Ridge Holland learned his craft from some of the biggest names in British wrestling, but he now sits under the learning tree of perhaps the best brawler in WWE history.
A man you definitely don't want to start a fight with.
You know that old adage, speak softly and carry a big stick, will certainly apply to this man.
Holland going to let his power speak for him tonight. fatal four-way rules, meaning no countouts, no disqualifications, anything goes. We're about to witness a very fast-paced match with Happy Corbin, Gunther, Ivar, and Rich Holland.
It's no coincidence why this match is called a fatal four-way. Things can become catastrophic for any competitor at the blink of an eye.
And having no rules just adds fuel to the flame. Oh, no, a sledgehammer.
They're calling paramedics right now.
Sledgehammer can cause some serious damage. Every successive move is putting their opponent in a dicey situation.
Corey, it kind of seems like the best way to win a fatal four-way would be to form an alliance.
It has to be a strategically temporary alliance for both parties. That means you're just waiting to see who stabs who in the back first. So my general recommendation would still be to not trust anybody but yourself.
Into the corner now.
DDT!
This match grinded him down a little.
There's a line to the back of the neck.
German suplex. Saw that one coming.
Boom. Boom. Nice.
He can do it here. Fended off a two count there.
Could be in search of a second win now.
All right, back to it. Returning to the ring. Sent crashing to the floor.
Our official just took a big hit.
Oh, come on. Let's keep it clean in there.
Fishing for something beneath the ring.
Oh, boy. That's a baseball bat. Hoping to end this match with one big swing.
Dribbling the opponent's head.
And here's a cover. Oh, my. How in the world did he kick out of that?
Frankly, he should have known that wasn't enough.
How humiliating. Just kicks to the face.
Snapmare.
Follows out a knee drop.
A fracture over it.
Intercepts that attack with a knee right to the stomach.
Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
A terrifying look for Ivar's opponent. Tag with a punch.
Looking for more damage here.
Release back suplex. Headlock cinched in. Just tossed without regard. Wow, clubbing blow to the back. This match's brutality starting to show on it.
This deep in fatal four-way match, it's a wonder they're not a little banged up. But the grueling nature of this match is definitely getting to them now, gentlemen. He's looking to unload on his opponent with that kendo.
Taking this moment to tease him with the kendo stick.
Storm Buster!
scored from these competitors. Both superstars showing great awareness of their opponent's repertoire.
Here is your winner, Happy Corbin!
After a memorable fatal four-way, here is our winner.
Yet another volatile and unpredictable match in the books.
I think any of those four superstars could have taken it.